We meet in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
It is good to see so many of our regular congregation, and quite a good number of children and their parents, thank you for bringing them along, from Soho Parish School. It is wonderful to have everybody here with us today, and I welcome very warmly those of you here perhaps for the first time, and I also welcome those joining us online from home, as we celebrate together the Feast of All Saints, which Father Paul will be telling us a little bit more about later in the service. Many of the children were at our harvest, I think all the children were at our harvest festival service at school on Tuesday. Can anybody remember what colour stoles Reverend Paul, myself and Reverend John were wearing? What colour? Can you remember? Maria Rosario is going red, green, yellow, green. It was, any idea? Yes? Oh, it wasn't purple, Chelsea, but thank you for guessing. I'll put you out of your misery. It was green, which is the colour for ordinary time of the year. Gold, like this, we reserve for special occasions. So when we remember the saints, we remember the company that gather around God's throne in heaven, but also people here on earth. And so we celebrate the gift of All Saints today. And so we begin our worship by singing together the great hymn for all the saints who from their labours rest.
Thank you.
pleased as you introduce the next part of the service for us.
As we celebrate the Feast of All Saints, we remember that we follow in the footsteps of Jesus' friends and disciples down the ages. As we gather here in St. Anne's and in other churches around the world, so the saints gather round the throne of God in worship. In the presence of God, let us ask forgiveness for any mistakes we have made in the week that has passed.
For anything unkind or mean-spirited we have thought, said, or done.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
For any harm we have caused to others or our world without thinking.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
For any opportunity to do good that we let pass us by.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Your glory is proclaimed in every age. As we rejoice in the faith of your saints, inspire us to follow their example with boldness and joy through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please do be seated now as Maria Rosario and Coco come and read to us our first reading. Come on up.
I could not number, and they were all praising the Lord with songs. In their midst was a young man, taller than any of the others. On the head of each of them he placed a crown, but was more exalted than they, and I was held spellbound. Then I asked an angel, "Who are these, my Lord?" He answered and said to me,
"These are they who have put off mortal clothing and put on immortality. They have confessed the name of God Now they are being crowned and receive leaves of palm.
Then I said to the angel, who is the young man who is placing crowns on them and putting palms in their hands? He answered and said to me,
he is the Son of God, whom they confess to the world.
So I began to praise those who had stood up for the name of the Lord. Then the angel said to me,
go, tell my people how great and how many are the wonders of the Lord God that you have seen.
Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Pass on now, and another cocoa is going to read for us. We have a plethora of cocoas in Seven Parish, but you can never have enough too many cocoas, I would say. Danny is going to play the organ very gently as you say this, please verse with a loud voice, to remind us that the Psalms were written not just to be spoken, but to be sung.
The earth is the Lord's and all that fills it.
For he has founded it upon the seas and set it firm upon the rivers of the deep.
He shall ascend the hill of the Lord, of who can rise up in his holy place.
Those who have clean hands and a pure heart, who have not lifted up their soul to an idol, nor sworn an oath to a lie.
They shall receive a blessing from the Lord, a just reward of their salvation.
Such is the company of those who seek him, of those who seek your face, O God of Jacob. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Would you please stand for the reading of the Holy Gospel?
The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way, they persecuted the prophets who were before you. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Alleluia, Alleluia.
Please do sit down, everybody. Yes, so today, as you've heard, we are celebrating the Feast of All Saints. And some of you, I think most of you, will have found in your orders of service a little card about this sort of size. So hang on to those, look after them, because you'll need them a bit later on. Now, I wonder if anyone can tell me what or who a saint is. The end. I'll have a go. Well, that's a great answer. That's a great answer. So anyone who didn't hear Theo, someone recognised for their life in their fellowship of Jesus, and recognised after their death, which is interesting. So that is one of the meanings of saints. It's not the only one. And in fact, on your cards, you'll see many saints who have died on earth, and the church affirms rejoice now in heaven. Any other ideas? Okay, indeed, us, by virtue of being followers of Christ. That's right. So the meaning of saint in the fullest sense, in the way it's used in the Bible, is for us. And I want a last question. Can anyone name me a saint or their favourite saint, especially any of the children, if you have thought, Esma?
St. Anne.
St. Anne, yes, indeed. I wonder, can you remember who St. Anne is? No. She's anyone? Chelsea? Indeed, the mother of Mary. The mother who was the mother of Jesus, of course. Okay, so we've got examples there. Well, so saint, quite literally, as Pierre actually mentioned, it means someone who's holy. Holy one. Holy, what does holy mean? Holy is one who is set apart. But set apart in a good way. That is, they stand out, you might say stand out in a crowd about as to who they are. Now, in our gospel reading we had, Jesus describes what it means to be a saint, one of his followers who would stand out in the world. Now, this reading that we had, blessed are the poor in spirit and so on, are known as the Beatitudes. That's the name that has been given to them, a Latin word meaning blessings, the Beatitudes. And you might have heard in the Bible, early on in the Bible, about a person called Moses, who also stood on a mountain and spoke to his people. And he gave what's called the Ten Commandments, which is many, many centuries before Jesus. The Ten Commandments were lots of thou shalt do this, thou shalt not do that. And in contrast, Jesus' Beatitudes are not a list of what we should do and what we shouldn't do. Rather, they're descriptions of who a saint is, what sort of person they are, what their character is, we might say, not what we should or shouldn't do. We're not told, for example, blessed are those who go to school, although that's a very good thing to do. We're not told, blessed are those who go to church, although that's a very good thing to do as well. We're not even told, blessed are those who give to the poor, although that is also a very good thing to do. So what do the Beatitudes say about Christian character? Now, I'll have a go at explaining best I can. Blessed are the poor in spirit. This might mean saints trust God's power and loving care, and they know they need it. Blessed are those who mourn. Now, this refers to mourning about the state of the world. This time you may have heard the phrase climate grief, this idea of feeling sadness for what is happening to our planet. This is a sense of those who mourn, and so we say that saints are sad or angry because there's some unfairness or something that's wrong about the world. Blessed are the meek. So saints are ordinary, humble people, not necessarily spectacularly good at something. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. And what does that mean? Well, saints wish most of all to do what is right according to God. Go on to the last few. Blessed are the merciful, the pure in heart, and the peacemakers. So saints are kind, gentle, and understanding people. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake. Well, saints also get into trouble sometimes for following Jesus. So you can't make yourself do lots of things to become a saint. It's what a person is like, their character. So Jesus is the ultimate example of having this character of the Beatitudes. But with God's help, we can grow into this character. Now, in the church, we've recognised, as Theo mentioned, certain people whose lives, and sometimes even the way they died, showed that they modelled this character of the Beatitudes. Now, we believe that these people who are now in heaven are close to God and praise and worship him in heaven. Coco and Maria Rosario read about them earlier, like this. A great multitude that I could not number, and they all were praising the Lord with songs. So the saints in heaven and the saints among us on earth are all part of the church, all praising God. Okay, what about those little cards that you should have in your orders of service? Have a look at those. Now, you might recognise some of them, you might not recognise some of them. Some of them may not be familiar, others might be very familiar. And on the back, you'll see a little description. Do you have a little read of what the description says? Or if you have difficulty with that, do ask a grown-up next to you if you can't read that. I'm going to read out three of these characteristics from the Beatitudes again. And if this might describe your saint, I'm going to ask you to put up your hand. And then we'll light a candle, put some candles out. And to give thanks for these saints who've gone before us and for the examples that they have given us. I'll pop those there. So here's the first one. Saints trust God's power and loving care and know they need it. Saints trust God's power and loving care. Chelsea, who do you have?
Saint Anne and Blessed Virgin Mary.
Wonderful. There we are. Can you read out what it says on the card? Yeah. If I can mirror you with the microphone, I'll be able to.
Saint Anne was the mother of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Saint Anne dedicated her daughter to the service of God, trusting in God's power and care for Mary. Mary would be the mother of Jesus.
Thank you, Chelsea. Anyone else demonstrated that they trusted in God's loving care? Louise?
Saint George.
Ah, Saint George. Do you read that, Saint George? Ah, very good. Well, we'll comment a bit more about that as well in a minute. Okay, let's read another one. Saints wish most of all to do what is right according to God. Saints wish most of all to do what is right. I think I can see Connaught. Connaught, I'll comment over so that people can hear, or so that those at home can hear you read that out.
Saint Benedict's wish most of what to do is right, according to God. So wrote a book on how communities should live together in love and service. Today, communities of Christians follow Saint Benedict's advice, which is called the Rule of Saint Benedict.
Thank you, Connaught. That's an interesting one. Saint Benedict, who set out an idea of how Christians might be able to live together in a community. And this really led to communities of monks and nuns living together, but also has formed ways of communities now who've tried to live together. And we've heard one of these already. I'll see if we can have any others. Here we are, saints get in trouble for following Jesus. We hear that from St. George. We have Coco. Oh, I'll just come over the microphone.
St. Christopher carried a child across a river, and the child revealed himself as Jesus. By helping those in need, we are serving Jesus. St. Christopher was beheaded by the Roman authorities because he was Christian. He got in trouble for following Jesus. St. Christopher is the patron saint of travellers.
Thank you very much, Coco. There, St. Christopher, who is a very popular saint. Some people carry little St. Christopher on a little chain sometimes because he's the patron saint of travellers. And there you often see a picture of him with a child on his shoulders. And the story goes that he helped a child across a river who turned out to be Jesus. And this is a legend, you might say, a story to teach us that by helping those in need, we are serving Jesus. And as we heard from Coco, very sadly, he stood up for his Christian faith and he was put to death by the Romans. Now, many Christian saints died as a result of Roman persecution very early on in the history of the church. Okay. So, I'm going to light some candles as we remember these saints who have given the demonstrations of the character of what it means to be a Christian following the Beatitudes of Jesus. So we give thanks for those saints who trusted God's power and loving care. We pray that we might trust in God and know that we need him. And we give thanks for those saints who wish most of all to do what is right. We pray that we would follow their example as well. Some of you might have had St. Francis or St. Clare of Assisi, who gave up lots of their wealth so that they could live out Jesus' call to help the poor. And we give thanks for those saints who got in trouble for following Jesus. And we pray that we might have the courage to stand up for what is right, even if we might get teased for it or get in trouble, hopefully not necessarily paying the ultimate price like St. George or St. Catherine or St. Christopher. So I would invite you to take away your little cards, and you can sort of keep them, you can use them as bookmarks, quite handy, to sort of remind you of this service and remind you of those saints who've gone before us. But always remember, of course, that the saints are those who've gone before us and those who are around us. And we have to be alert for the Christian character that we might be able to look up to and emulate and act out in our own lives. So we close with a prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you for the example of the saints. Help us know our need of you, our God, and to trust your power and loving care. Help us, O God, to wish most of all to do what is right according to you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Father Paul. Now, the saints are often pictured in heaven, surrounding God's throne and singing. And as Colin pointed out, saints are all of us in different ways. And we have some special saints with us today. Christine is going to conduct as they sing for us now. And so it's lovely to have members of the school choir come out if you're singing for us now. You'll sing another piece at the end of the service. But for now, a little song, not so much about saints, but about this time of year, autumn.
Autumn is here again. See the colors red.
invite you to stand and, using the words on page 8, say the words of the short creed there together. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated now as we come to our time of intercession.
So Heavenly Father, we pray for the church, for your saints here on earth. Come into our lives so we might grow to be more like your Son and follow the example of the saints that are with you in heaven. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for Soho High School. O God, help our pupils, parents, careers and staff to build a school community full of life and love that comes from you. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for our world. O God, guide our world leaders as they make decisions that affect our planet at the COP26 Climate Change Conference. Help us care for our world and its future and everyday lives. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for Christians persecuted for their faith, for the child bullied in India for being a Christian, for the mother imprisoned in Pakistan for her faith in Jesus. O God, make persecutors turn from evil and know your mercy and the love of Jesus. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those in need. O God, bring healing where there is hurt and suffering. O God, lift up those who are down. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And let us pray for those who grieve and for those who have died. Father of mercy, comfort those who mourn, and prepare us and all who have died to join you, St. Anne, the Blessed Virgin Mary, and all the saints in the home you have prepared for us in heaven. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Would you please stand and see? Now is your turn to come out and read a sentence for us.
We are citizens together with the saints and the household of God through Christ our Lord, who came and preached peace to those who were far and to those who were near.
Beautifully done. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please greet one another as best you can with a sign of God's peace whilst maintaining a degree of social distancing. Peace be with you over on that side.
Peace be with you.
And I invite you now to be seated as the altar is prepared, a collection is taken, and we sing the chant on the sheet. Also, during this part of the service, because it is All Saints Day, we'll be using incense at the altar. And one of the children, I think, Paul, you're going to get to come and help.
Maybe.
Over to you. Yeah. You choose.
front for a moment. You have to come help for a moment at the moment.
The Lord be with you.
And also
lift up your hearts.
Lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And now we give you thanks, most gracious God, surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses, and glorified in the assembly of your saints. The glorious company of apostles praise you. The noble fellowship of prophets praise you. The white-robed army of martyrs praise you. We, your holy church, acclaim you. In communion with angels and archangels, and with all who served you on earth and worship you now in heaven, we raise our voice to proclaim your glory, ever praising you and singing.
Thank you.
praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took a cup of wine. Again, he praised you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Bringing before you, O Lord, this bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people. Gather us in your loving arms and bring us with the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Anne, and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven, through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever. Saints and martyrs for the ages, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God. Please be seated now and wait to be called forward to receive communion or a blessing. If you normally receive communion you're in another church, you're welcome to receive here or come forward to receive a blessing. There are quite a lot of us, so ignore the blue dots on the floor today, but just keep a little bit of distance according to how many Mark sends up to receive or John. Let us pray. A prayer for us to say together on page 14 of our Orders of Service. Lord of Heaven, in this Eucharist you have brought us near to a great company of angels and to the spirits of the saints made perfect. As in this food of our earthly pilgrimage we have shared their fellowship, so may we come to share their joy in heaven. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We stand to sing our closing hymn, O praise ye the Lord, praise him in the height. First thing I want just to say is how lovely it is to see everybody here this morning. It's great to have you with us. I hope you've enjoyed being here at St. Anne's. And do remember, we are open every Sunday, and you're welcome anytime. And during the week, we're unusual amongst those churches in central London whose doors are open every single day, and it's the churches open to serve the whole community. So if you're in Soho and you want a little bit of a moment of peace and quiet, do come and spend a moment in the chapel. That's what it's there for. Everybody's invited to stay for refreshments afterwards, which Peter will have the kettle on. Well, he had on the kettle a week ago, to be honest, because he likes to be prepared. Do stay and have refreshments after the service. If you need to slip away, of course, straight away, we understand. And Father Paul and I will be at the entrance with a couple of bits of chocolate, maybe, for those who like that sort of thing. That'll be me then. Next Sunday is Remembrance Sunday. And our service begins in the gardens at 10:55. So as long as the weather is good, head straight into the gardens. If it's really bad, then come straight into church. But no matter what the weather's doing, the service will begin at 5 to 11, so we can keep the 2 minutes silence. School are also gathering on the Thursday, the 11th. Thank you, Louise, for yes, nodding, tell me I'm on the right track, at about 10 to 11. So also, if you're around in Soho next Thursday morning, and you'd like to gather at the War Memorial on the Tower in the gardens, again, you're very welcome to do that. There are a couple of other things just to notice on your back of your orders of service. Please just see what's coming up here, including the Requiem here at 5 o'clock tonight and the film. Yesterday was a special day in the life of St. Anne's, but a particularly special day in the life of one of our very beloved members. Mark Allen was amongst 72 people being confirmed by the Bishop of London in quite a long service, it has to be said, last night, but a joyful occasion. Mark, stand up so people can remember who you are. So Mark has been with us for the last 3 years, roughly 2-3 years. Soho resident, faithful in prayer, growing in faith. And Mark, it's great that the bishop was able to lay hands on you last night and confirm your faith before a good old crowd in St. Paul's.
It was wonderful.
And we had a drink afterwards to celebrate.
We did.
And we'll celebrate again, but with a cup of tea now. But Mark, we gave you presents to mark the special occasion on a card last night. But every blessing from all of us here as you continue as one of God's saints shining here in Soho.
Thank you.
Last but not least, we enjoyed the choir earlier on, did we not?
Yeah.
I think we'd like to hear some more. So can I call the choir up so that after I've given the blessing, you're ready to sing for us another very appropriate song for All Saints Day, The Harvest Samba. Would everybody please stand? Children, come out and gather ready to sing. And I'll also just add a word of thanks to the Cocos and the Z's and the Maria Rosarios who have read for us, and Chelsea, who have read for us beautifully today. We do call these Soho Parish Sundays, but they are also for Soho Parish alumni, people who have been to Soho Parish, and also other young people who have not been to Soho Parish at all, but have just missed out on that great joy and pleasure. As your children turn, and Louise, turn and face me for the blessing, and then you can turn and face Christine as she waves her hands in front of you. God give you joy in his service and strengthen you in faith. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you this day and always.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ.
Amen. Good investment. And we're enjoying it too, because you can see that. Please be safe and have some refreshments.